Hello, my name is Rachel Huddart and I'm a scientific curator at FarmGKB. In this video, we're going to do a walkthrough of FarmGKB's variant annotations and clinical annotations. Before we begin, a quick note to say that our YouTube playlist of FarmGKB walkthroughs contains videos looking at other types of annotations on FarmGKB, as well as a walkthrough of the full site. FarmGKB captures pharmacogenetics results from peer-reviewed published research papers as variant and clinical annotations. A variant annotation is a single sentence which records a single finding from a single paper. If a paper reports multiple findings, for example if the researchers looked at several different variants, it will have multiple variant annotations on FarmGKB. Our clinical annotations bring together variant annotations and other pieces of curated evidence to summarise what's known about a particular variant-drug phenotype relationship. We assign a level of evidence to all clinical annotations to indicate the strength of the underlying evidence base. We'll go into this in more detail later in the video. This is the FarmGKB homepage. Most visitors to FarmGKB are looking for information about a specific drug or gene. I'm going to use the search box to search for atorvastatin. You'll see that suggestions appear as I type, or I can hit return and bring up the full list of search results. I'm interested in seeing all the variant and clinical annotations that FarmGKB has on atorvastatin, so I'm going to go to the atorvastatin drug page. Every drug, gene, variant, and phenotype in FarmGKB has its own page like this one. The menu on the left shows the different types of information that are available in FarmGKB, and the blue dots show that there is information relative to, in this case, atorvastatin. You'll see that there are blue dots on the clinical annotations and variant annotations tabs. We're going to look at a variant annotation first, then move on to clinical annotations. This table shows all the variant annotations on atorvastatin. If I scroll along the table, you'll see that it shows the main features of each annotation, including any reported p-values and the cohort size. I'm going to look at this variant annotation in more detail. The main part of a variant annotation is this sentence at the top, which describes the finding. Curators at FarmGKB construct these sentences from sets of control terms. Although this means that the sentence may not be in perfect, grammatically correct English, doing this makes it easier to compare variant annotations against each other. If a curator needs to add information that isn't covered by the main sentence, they can add free text in this section. In this case, there are more details about the significance of the association, and a note to say that the curator has complemented the alleles to the positive strand. FarmGKB reports all alleles as being on the positive strand. This allows us to maintain consistency across the thousands of variants throughout the genome which we annotate on. You can also see details about the variants and genes associated with this annotation, the phenotype category assigned to the annotation, and whether the paper reports that the association was significant. Variant annotations and clinical annotations are assigned to one of the following phenotype categories: dosage, efficacy, toxicity, metabolism or PK, PD, or other. Assignment of a phenotype category is based on the content of the annotation. Using these categories allows curators and users to easily group and compare similar annotations across FarmGKB. Coming back to the variant annotation and moving further down the page, we capture information about the study cohort and any statistical analyses in the study parameters. As you can see, variant annotations can have multiple study parameters. This is typically done when multiple analyses looking at the same association are carried out. In this case, the paper reports the effect of the association on three different cholesterol measurements. So three different sets of study parameters have been added to the annotation. Like all other annotations on FarmGKB, variant annotations have a history log where changes to the annotation are recorded. As we saw earlier, variant annotations are used as evidence in clinical annotations. This section shows you if the variant annotation has been linked to any clinical annotations. We're going to take a look at this clinical annotation, which brings together the evidence for an association between the variant RS20455 and atorvastatin efficacy. Clinical annotations give genotype or allele-specific summaries of a gene-drug association. The summaries are written relative to the other alleles or genotypes in the annotation. On the left side, you can see the genes, drugs, and phenotypes which are covered by the annotation. All clinical annotations are assigned a level of evidence by PharmGKB curators. This shows the strength of evidence supporting the association. You can learn more about our levels of evidence by clicking on the eye icon. Our levels of evidence run from level 1, showing the strongest evidence, to level 4, which indicates that the evidence does not support the presence of an association. Clinical annotations can move up or down levels as curators add new supporting or conflicting evidence. We use an algorithm to assign a level of evidence to our clinical annotations. Details of how the algorithm works are given on this page. There's also a link in the description below for a video which walks through each step of the algorithm. If we scroll down the clinical annotation page, we get to the evidence that has been attached to this annotation. We give a breakdown of the clinical annotation score and what types of evidence are attached to the annotation, then list out each piece of evidence underneath. It's important to note that a clinical annotation score is only used to assign a level of evidence and shouldn't be used to compare or rank clinical annotations within the same level of evidence. Each of these boxes is a variant annotation, which shows a single finding from a single publication. All relevant variant annotations are added to a clinical annotation, regardless of whether they support the association or not. This helps to assign an accurate level of evidence. This is the variant annotation that we looked at earlier. Because the direction of the association here is opposite to that described in the other variant annotations, it has been tagged as conflicting evidence. As with the variant annotations, clinical annotations have a history section at the bottom of the page. If you have any questions about the material covered in this video, please contact us at feedback@farmgkb.org. Thank you.